We all know we should eat healthy food, and we'd eat a lot more of it if it didn't often taste like the front lawn. Instead of eating our veggies, we scarf down the good-tasting, bad stuff. But junk food junkies are about to become history. Soon, even Brussels sprouts could taste like cream puffs.
This may look like your typical swanky Midtown Manhattan party, but it's a little different. This is a taste-tripping party, and these food gatherings are popping up all over the country. The theory is that this West African berry, known as a miracle fruit, changes anything that tastes sour sweet for the next hour. Sounds a little trippy. I'm gonna give it a shot. Here we go.
With this one little berry, red wine goes down like juice.
Oh my God, this is dangerous. This is so good.
Cheers. It's a sweet, sweet wine.
Meat turns sweet.
Let's go with a candy.
Grapefruit is sour free. And blue cheese on bread tastes like jam on toast.
They call me the miracle fruit man.
Curtis Mosey has an orchard of 40,000 miracle fruit trees in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. He's hoping we're all going to fall in love with this little red berry.
The miracle fruit originates from Africa. Normally it's found in Ghana and Nigeria. Some of the Africans use it for acute coughs, malaria. Also, some of the women use the miracle fruit when they are breastfeeding. They would take some of the fruit and rub it on their nipples. When infants are sucking milk, they would drink more milk. It was introduced to the United States in 1952. The first time I tried the miracle fruit, the seed was implanted in my head to make sure everyone in the world was exposed to the miracle fruit. Well, the proper way to eat a miracle fruit is to put one in your mouth, remove everything off the seed using your teeth and tongue, and swirl it around in your mouth for about approximately 60 seconds and discard the pit. The lemon tastes like lemonade. That was delicious.
To learn how this miracle fruit brings a fantastic flavor to everything, we head to the University of Florida in Gainesville, where a team of culinary crusaders takes its taste buds on safari.
It continues to get sweeter, and that's when you know that you've gotten the full effect.
The savory secret is the berry's active ingredient, a protein called miraculin.
You've got the miraculin protein, and it's got sugar molecules up on it. Now, here's the sweet receptor over here, and the sweet receptor is just out of reach. So you change the conformation of the sweet receptor, and they hit. And then essentially the same sugar molecules pop on and off and on and off and on and on. So you get a tremendous amount of sweet taste generated with a small number of molecules.
As a senior professor of dentistry at UF, Dr. Linda Bartoshuk has a professional interest in convincing people to put the right stuff in their mouths.
Do you mind having your tongue painted blue?
Not at all.
We know that the love of sweet is hardwired. You're not going to change that. And this is what makes miracle fruit so interesting, because it's a way to manipulate sweet.
The human tongue has about 3,000 taste buds, which recognize 5 taste sensations: sweet, sour, salty, bitter, and something called umami. As best we can tell, miraculin makes the taste buds that normally react to sugars also respond to acids, which are usually associated with sour. The result? Lemons taste like bonbons. Off-putting flavors become seductively sweet.
But you put this in your mouth, and the slightly sour taste of the fruit will turn deliciously sweet. Miracle fruit adds an intense sweet taste whenever there's acid in your mouth.
And this works on anything you eat. Squash and string beans become as sinfully good as a sugary snack.
We're just absolutely amazed that this berry could have such properties. Basically coats the tongue and fools it into thinking that sour things are sweet.
Dr. David Clark, a horticultural biologist, knows that more people will pleasure their palates with healthy helpings if he can get miraculin out of these berries and into our veggies.
since we know how to genetically engineer a vast number of crops, such as tomato and strawberry, we have the ability to introduce this gene into those plants and make them taste sweeter.
If it works, a stalk of broccoli could taste like ice cream, and eating your greens will be a tempting treat. To guide miraculin's properties into the structure of food, Dr. Kevin Folta uses a molecular escort, the GFP, or green fluorescent protein gene, the same stuff that makes jellyfish glow.
So each one of these green spots represents a cell that has the miraculin gene along with this GFP gene. This way we know it worked.
No, your dinner won't glow. The GFP gene is just a tag to show researchers that they've succeeded in installing the miraculin additive. These strawberry seeds now have miraculin genes in their DNA.
It's a laboratory line of strawberry that's related to a wild strawberry that produces a yellow fruit. So we don't get the traditional large red fruits.
The strategy of a yellow strawberry is to make it distinct from its traditional red relatives.
You would recognize this as either the power berry or the flavor berry or some other kind of designation that we'd come up with, where you'd eat this first, and then you could enjoy the rest of the strawberries that would even be sweeter than they normally are.
Soon we'll just pop a power berry, and the next thing we eat will be a sweet treat.
Wouldn't it be great if we could take the foods we don't want kids to eat and make them disliked, and take the foods we want them to eat and make them liked?
If a side of lima beans tastes as yummy as jelly beans, kids at last will clean their plates. Now, let's try miraculin on something with a bit more bite.
I'm about to drink Tabasco. That's crazy. But I got miracle fruit, let's see what it does. It's great.
Woo!